that becomes kama, endless desire. Non-happiness of a person, hatredness of a person results in conflict, that results in enmity, hostility, mass genocide, total annihilation of the world. All sorts of brutalities raise their heads if they are not properly taken care. So these two heads of kama and krodha are at that extreme ends, which is the basis of today's topic. Corruption is the result of kama and terrorism is the result of krodha. Corruption comes out of kama. This is the psychoanalytical as well as anthropophilosophical study of corruption as well as terrorism. And number two, as it is in the socio-anatomical or socio-physiological system, the salubrity of the social body is governed by various factors. Likewise, various evil intrusions are there, which have been removed by the socio-pathological method of revolution, renaissance, advice, dedication to the society by exercises, administrative justice, retributive and contributive justice, the form of judiciary, innumerable other things are there mentioned in society for socio-pathology. And to understand the socio-etiology, that is, the disease structure of the society, we have to understand that corruption is like a peripheral psoriasis. And it is a cancer inside, which is very morbid, and it is very vulnerable also to the human body, which is the case of the terrorism. It is a total immune deficiency in the case of terrorism like AIDS. And it is like cardiac arrest also at the time of creating some sort of unprecedented, unpredictable, untold miseries and cycles of perpetual melancholy in the society. So these things are like diseases of the social organism. In the case of unpredictability, they are like cardiac arrest, immediate and effective. In that cruelty, in that dispersibility, in that permeation, they are like psoriasis, they are ugly contents of the society. They totally make the society to be immunodeficient in securities of investment, economic, just general social, health issues, political issues, social integrity, mutuality, and various other walks of life. It made the society totally immunodeficient. So it is the AIDS of the society, it is the cardiac arrest of the circulatory system of the society, it is a cancerous verge, it is also a psoriatic permeation or radiation in the socio-pathological issue as a challenge. So this concern of these things as a disease has made us to do more research on these issues, bringing us the real solutions as well to solve the problem. The third thing is that I want to say here, for every problem there will be two units or two states. One is the fundamental unit, second is the derivation unit. The fundamental units or the fundamental status which has resulted in this big problem is, it is bilateral, it is parallel. One is the education system, second is the ruling system. Education system, that is when the base or foundation in which values are instilled, inculcated by means of inspiration, not only by inculcation, the inspiration that we derive from the masters. Creating environmental conduciveness, making a person to be properly molded, that is the duty of education industry, let us say. And ruling industry, who have to be the caretakers, monitors, observers and rectifiers of all of these problems, that has also resulted in total aberration. So the aberration of the foundation as well as the ceiling of the total system of good governance or ethical or moral constructivism in the society, that has resulted in all derivative aberrations. What are they? We are having problems in media, we are having problems in education, then in medical industries, then in judiciaries, then in sports, then in fuel services and supplies, then civology, electoral supplies are also there. Electoral reforms are, everybody is discussing in a democratic country about electoral reforms, that they should be more digital and powerful, more watchy, more vigilant and meticulous so that proper selection can be exercised. So all of these multiple things, including spiritual corruption, religious corruption, electoral corruption, then health services corruption, then even domestic corruption, there is also corruption in love and harmony. There is no true love, there is no true relation, there is no true bondage, there is no true affection. Everywhere, in each and everything, food is corrupted, water is corrupted, air is corrupted. So whatever we are seeing is a global network of corruption. And how to remove that? What is corruption? They have given a lot of definitions. There are some serious industrialists who are into this corruption mechanism as well as corruption identification, rectification processes. Like Mike P. Wang, he is a very great research scholar in corruption and corruption distribution and exhibition services. He has defined it is the utility of something that is allocated for a common cause or a major cause or for a different cause or a strange cause to divert the same thing for a person's individual specific benefits. And that is very thing some, I don't want to call it as something narrow and prosaic. Corruption as per our description in Shastras, it is having 10 major dimensions. One is something to be done. If somebody is demanding some favor, that is known as corruption. It is corruption to do, in which we are qualified, we are really eligible to get that. So to do something which we ought to get, number one. Number two, to selectively do something, to do something to a group of people in which we have to be selectively maintained by them or manipulated or guarded by them. It is not a selective doing. Third thing is breach doing, in which a person who is not qualified, he should be assured, he should be urged to get that benefit. That is known as breach doing. Fourth thing is somewhere to maintain silence, that is not to do something against us, but also corruption is being given. That is known as not to do anything. Fifth thing is double benefit or dual benefit, in which bribe is got from either sides. And multiple benefit is from all possible sources. It is a thousand euro structure to get the bribe or to get the benefit in any other form from all other places that is there. And one more corruption is very interesting. To get the bribe and not doing that, it is known as dishonest dishonesty. Getting a bribe is dishonest. But if a person gets the bribe and has the work done, that is honest dishonesty. And getting the bribe and not doing that is dishonest dishonesty. That is an advanced level of computing in corruption studies. And one more thing is that it is not a serious demand. I don't want to explain this. It happened in various other places wherever the life of a person, the dignity of a person, the morale of a person, they have been demanded as a cash or time. This is not a serious demand. This is also a type of corruption. Serious demand, you need something else. And one more thing I want to add as per the Vedas, if you are less productive or non-productive to your job, you are also corrupt. And betrayal is also the final tool of corruption. So to do, to selectively do, to violate and do, not to do something, dual benefit, multiple benefit, getting something and not doing something, the thing that has been desired by the person, and some sort of strain and serious and severe demand, and also to be non-productive or less productive than your ability, to undergo the benefit of cheating a nation, depriving its benefit by means of betrayal, working for somebody else. So these things are the dimensions of corruption in a wider spectrum as per the studies of the Vedas. And also we want to say there are individual traditions as per the Western sense also. There is nepotism. Not only cash transaction is known as bribery, corruption is not only financial or monetary or something connected with cash or kind. It is favored in different parts of life. That we are psychologically, that we are biologically, that we are ontologically, plurologically connected, even under all such dimensions, wherever we are against the rule, it is known as corruption. So nepotism is there. Nepotism is giving the favor of one's own relations and promoting them. Promoting one's own relatives and creating a relative affinity inside your official or professional background, it is known as nepotism. Embrace is there, it is backward entry. Bribery is there, offering something which they demand, that is known as bribery, which is very common. So like that, individual things are there. Group bias is there. Totally having an ethnic as well as renewal or religious attachment or happiness towards the people, that is also group bias. That is also a type of corruption. And there is ethno-nepotism. Totally supporting a particular caste, a particular group of people, totally disparaging a particular group of people, that is known as ethno-nepotism. These things are innumerable such things are there in the system. And one more thing which is now just blooming in the society, it is known as patronizing the friends, those who are associated with us, patronizing them.